Ha! So I got Kevin a pet to teach him responsibility. At first he just seemed really curious, but as the days have gone on, I can tell that he is convinced those things are evil and he must destroy them. Good thing I sprung for the fish tank that could support the weight of a fat, furry, four-legged slob. Not you, Sean.
None taken.
But here's the thing, Kevin is not too far off. Things that lurk in the water of video games are generally up to no good and ready to bite you in half. So here are the top 5 most evil fish in video games. Cute but deadly. It's the worst combination. Number 5, Linda the Lungfish from Psychonauts. No camper is safe with such a creature lurking beneath Lake Oblongata.
You don't got nothing to worry about. Except for that giant monster in the lake I was telling you about.
This giant scary lungfish used to be a regular lungfish, but was hideously mutated with a mind control implant so Coach Oleander could use it to kidnap children and bring them back to Thorny Tower's home for the disturbed. But no fear, our favorite Psychonaut to the rescue! Raz was using bathyspheres before Bioshock made it cool, and after an initial boss fight with the fish, Raz enters Linda's mind to visit the charming Lungfishopolis and destroy the mind control chip. So I guess this evil fish does turn good, that's why he's number 5. Next! Number 4, Anko the Lanternfish boss from Mega Man 2. A mini-boss in Bubble Man's stage, Anko releases Robo Shrimp, or Shrinks, from his mouth. It's actually kind of gross. Vomiting up shrimp, really? That's what you came up with? You were sitting around with Dr. Wily and you both agreed that spitting out crustaceans at a man with a cannon for an arm was a good defense? Okay. Anko is almost as bad as the other Mega Man fish I hate, those damn propeller fish from Splash Woman's stage in Mega Man 9, who just kind of torpedo at you. Like every Mega Man enemy, they are really f***ing annoying! But again, really? Shrimp spitting? Number 3, Lurker Sharks from Jak and Daxter. These things are surprisingly scary. It seems they were included as a clever way to keep players from swimming out too far to sea. In most games, if you swim out too far, you'll hit an invisible wall. A gentle reminder saying, hey, hi, don't go that way, we didn't develop that area and you'll get lost. Because you're stupid. Crysis also has sharks that serve as level boundaries, and you may be thinking, those are way scarier than the bright orange cartoony lurker sharks. But whatever, who cares? They're all terrifying. This is why I hate the ocean. Number 2, the whole Cheep Cheep family from the Mario series. Just all of them. First, there's just the Cheep Cheeps in general. They've been jumping out of the water and nipping at our ankles for years. Evil little bastards. Then found in Super Mario Bros. 3, the best Mario, there's Boss Bass and Big Bertha. Boss Bass attacks at the surface, and Bertha resides as a bottom dweller. Evil large bastards. Then why not? Let's add spikes. Porky Puffers came about in Super Mario World, and what more do you need? They're a combo of Puffer and Porcupine. Evil pokey bastards. And the number one most evil fish in all of video games? It's Bob the Killer Goldfish from Earthworm Jim.
If only I weren't stuck in this stupid bowl, I'd conquer the universe!
We should have seen this day coming. Sweet, innocent goldfish are sick of being won at carnivals by irresponsible kids and stone teenagers and taken home only to die a day later from being dumped into a Kool-Aid pitcher and fed Dorito crumbs. The goldfish of doom himself, Bob is taking a stand for goldfish everywhere. I'm not measuring this by difficulty because let's face it, Bob has never really been that hard to beat. But from an evil standpoint, Bob is as power hungry as they come. He even convinced a large cat whom he named Number 4 to carry him around in a fishbowl and do his bidding. Okay, now I understand what's going on here. That's it for Top 5. Tweet all your love, hate, and respectful disagreements to @LisaFoyles, and I will see you next week for another Top 5. I hope Kevin's fish are still alive by then. Probably not. He's not good at feeding them. Very irresponsible, actually.